There was a time when it wasn't unusual to see a blunt-nosed leopard lizard in the hills of western Fresno County. But habitat loss put this animal on the endangered species list in the mid-60s. By 2020, biologists believed the number of lizards on the Pinoche Plateau was actually under 10. The future of this subpopulation wasn't bright.
We are, for the first time ever, releasing captive-reared blunt-nosed leopard lizards back into the wild.
The future is certainly brighter now after the recent release of 10 blunt-nosed leopard lizards, animals bred in captivity at the Fresno Chaffee Zoo, where they grew without a threat of predators to a size they could be put back into the wild and potentially thrive.
Hopefully what will happen is that we'll see that we can not only successfully breed blunt-nosed leopard lizards in captivity, but that they are successful on the landscape when we reintroduce them, and that they in turn create a natural breeding population out on the landscape.
It's not just biologists from the California Department of Fish and Wildlife and the Fresno Chaffee Zoo working to save these lizards. The Bureau of Land Management, U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, and Fresno State University are also playing key roles in this project. 6 adult lizards were collected from these hills to be founders for the breeding program. 3 years later, 10 have been released. The goal is to release 80 to 100 per year until monitoring indicates the Pinoche Plateau blunt-nosed leopard lizards have achieved self-sufficiency.
And one of the reasons the partnership with the zoo is so important is that, they have expertise in animal husbandry and how to grow reptiles. They do that with a lot of different species, never with blunt-nosed before, but they have the expertise to figure it out, and they certainly did.
Figuring it out, as she says, is the goal for assisting other species as well.
The more we delve into the true story of conservation, the more we're telling a story of systems, of connectivity, of the importance at every level of a healthy, functioning ecosystem. So something like the blunt-nosed leopard lizard can really be the story that tells the larger story. The success of this animal, our work to do it collectively to save this animal, is the kind of inspiring story, even at the smallest scale, that gets people to think, to make connections, and to sort of build this idea in their head that there is so much more going on at every level than we've ever thought about, and there's stories to tell about it.
The progress of this species will be closely monitored, thanks largely to radio signals indicating how the lizards disperse and which habitat they choose. Yes, those are actually transmitters and antennas attached to the 10 lizards, now roaming free, far from a zoo in Fresno, back where they belong.